Guys and girls, Billy here once again. Well, fellas, I'm at the back of my yard at the moment, and this little area here is just an area with a beautiful apricot tree and native plant species and so forth. But as you can see, it's quite bare in this area, and it's bare behind me. So what I'm planning on doing, guys, is planting as an experiment, fencing off this area right here, like into a big rectangle type shape, and planting a heap of local native grass and wildflower species. And also I'm going to be doing exactly the same at the front of my yard. At the moment, at the front of my yard is lawn. I've got a bloke with a bobcat coming in the next couple of weeks to remove all the lawn and to cover the lawn with some beautiful red Australian gravel, and that way I'm going to have the whole front of my yard covered in absolutely beautiful all West Australian local Dombeyong wildflowers and flora. So anyway, fellas, so this is what I've been doing lately when I go for walks. I've been doing this for quite a while, is collecting all local flora species, wildflowers and so forth. So there's all different types of grasses in here, and flowers, everlastings. This is called a beautiful everlasting, as you can hear if you hear with my finger. It's like paper when it dries out. So they're called everlastings because they literally last forever. If you pick them when they're fresh and you put them in a jar of water or something like that, they'll just last for years and years. So you can see here, I've got heaps of all different seeds and so forth. Like this one here is another type of everlasting, if you can see that all right. All those little tiny white flowers fall off, and that's how the seeds are formed. So all in here, I've got all different types of seeds and everything else. You can see nuts and all of that. There's one there, I'm unsure what that one is. Right there. So whenever I go for a walk, guys, I pick up beautiful pieces of species of grass and everything else like that, or seed pods and all that kind of stuff. Here's some she oak seeds, or the casuarina tree, similar to a casuarina tree. This is a species of she oak. You can just see all the little tiny those things there, those little white things there, my fingers. They all fly away and turn into new plants. So yeah, so that area here, and right down below just here, guys, we've got some, also been picking up species of fungi and other seeds. And the other day I ordered some beautiful mushroom spore prints to grow. So as you can see, I've got some button mushroom prints, portobello prints, and flat mushroom spore prints. I got these off eBay. So it's really getting really hot now, fellas, so I expect that these won't be able to be placed into the ground until the winter period, possibly, like when the first rain. So if anyone could please let me know when to put these spores in the ground, I really, really would appreciate it. I've got no experience of growing mushrooms. I really, really want to learn how to grow mushrooms. So please, if you've got any expertise in growing mushrooms, I'd really, really appreciate it. And just here, fellas, there's a few more different types of fungi. These are species of puffballs, so there's probably two or three different types of puffballs. So these ones here can be placed in the, basically crushed, and the spores can be spread at this time of the year right now, because that's when they're starting to dry out. So this one here is also a species of puffball, so the actual puffball's probably been blown away by the wind. It sits in there. I did have a couple of other nice little species of mushrooms that I found, but they could be in that box, so I tried to find them, as you can see here. So I'm going to put them in a dry place for the time being, and then I'm going to find a place to put them. These ones can't go in shady spots, but I've got a beautiful area set up for growing these beautiful portobello mushrooms and the edible mushrooms. So I'll go over and show you now what it looks like. So if anyone could recommend, give me hints on when to plant those spores, let me know. And please give me advice on any other spore prints, what I could buy, what are edible, because I really, really want to learn how to grow mushrooms and fungi. Also, guys, here's a couple of other seeds. This one here is called a kwangdong. You see how they're red? That means that that's ripe, so you can actually eat that now. This is what the seed looks like. So that's actually edible. It's like a kind of like a bitter kind of sweet taste. and people use these to make beautiful kwangdong jams. They've been, and obviously it's an Aboriginal bush tucker. And yeah, so early pioneers would use this fruit to make beautiful kwangdong jam. A couple of other seeds here, guys. I'm unsure what this one is. This one is, it looks like a kwangdong, but it's not. So I'll dry those out. This one here, unsure if this is a seed or if it's just like a host growth growing on this species of acacia. And yeah, also another little she-oak type seed. And I've also picked up some beautiful sandalwood seeds the other day. Here's a little one here. So there's the seed pods there, guys. You can just see there. So that's the seed pods there. So that's what I'm actually collecting, stuff like that, beautiful seed pods, and dry them out. And like I say, there's another beautiful plant species called the sandalwood tree. You probably would have heard about that. I've got heaps of those seeds. I want to grow those as well. So anyway, guys, I'll take you over where my mushroom area is going to be, and that's underneath this beautiful port Jackson fig tree, similar to a Moreton Bay fig. Absolutely beautiful tree, I call it a peace tree. And like I say, this whole area right here is going to be fenced off, and I'm going to plant all heaps of different species of wildflowers in this area. The only thing that concerns me is this awful couche grass, what I need to try and work out how to remove. I might even have to, I don't know, spray it possibly. I don't like using chemicals in my backyard. I haven't used them for years. But anyway, you spray them, they come back up anyway. So yeah, so we'll spread all these around this area, and also my whole area is going to be covered in stuff like this once all that beautiful gravel's down, guys. So probably in another year or two, I'm going to have an absolutely beautiful front yard, and I'll put all my, maybe some nice wagon wheels on display and relics and all that kind of stuff. So anyway, let's head over there, and like I say, if you're any mushroom experts, maybe DJ Puff the Third, my one of my best mates in England, who always helps me out with cactus species and other stuff, you might give me no info about that, DJ. And I love your help, mate. You're a champion bloke, as I always say. Like I say, guys, beautiful bush tucker here, and there's a few more little seed pods there, but I'm unsure what they are. But we'll dry them out, and one day we'll plant them in here in the front yard. So let's head over right now to the mushroom area, guys. Here, that's my pet magpie scrapper's cage. He's out wandering the yard at the moment. I'll let my beautiful magpies wander the yard while they're babies, and then I'll release them eventually. But right here, guys, I've got a heap of horse manure, leaf mulch and everything else, and I've got it all under cover shade. So this is going to be one of my areas here for growing mushrooms. So let me know, please, if any experts out there, when I start growing these mushrooms, because this is absolutely a beautiful, cool spot, as you can see. It's summer approaching. It's just basically spring. We're like a month into spring. So can I plant those spores now, the edible spores, or should I wait until winter approaches, autumn? Or so we'll lift this up, guys. I just don't want to break it. So this area here. So if anyone could recommend, should I plant those edible fungi spores here? Let me know, and when I do, should I keep this cover on top like it is now? And just here is another area where I want to grow mushrooms. So I've got it covered once again, and already you can just see all the white mold stuff starting to grow from the moisture. So yeah, I'd really appreciate, guys, and this beautiful whole area here. I'd love to have a mushroom garden, and this beautiful Port Jackson fig tree, fellas. You know, plant mushroom spores around the base of these tree roots. As you can see here, it's green from the algae, or whatever it's called, I forget what it's called, like lichen and that, when it gets wet. So a water spot like that be good for planting spores, you know. And yeah, basically I just want to plant any mushroom spores around this area here. So I know there's plenty of mushroom experts out there, so like I say, I'd really appreciate it, guys. And like I say, let me know about those ones, and please recommend any other edible mushrooms that I can order, because, and what websites to go to, because I really, really want to learn how to grow them, especially outside. I'd rather grow them outside than inside. All right, guys, appreciate you watching. All my old beautiful cow skulls and bird, all my bird boxes and stuff. I'm setting up heaps of bird boxes. They've been there for years. And I'm just about to set up a heap of bat boxes, guys. I've got hundreds of bats around this area. There could be even bats living in those little bird boxes, especially this one right up here. As you can see it in the sunlight. I don't know, I can't see it through the camera. But, oh, there it is, that one there. So there could be bats living in there at the moment. And much more. And also, fellas, I made plenty of videos about this little bird area I'm doing at the moment. So I'm learning how to grow cactus, guys. So if anyone can recommend any good cactuses that I can buy, please recommend them. I really want to learn how to grow cactuses. DJ, I know you're probably going to give me heaps of information about that, mate. So because he's an expert at growing cactus and stuff like that. And this is my beautiful bird area where I get heaps of birds. And I'm going to fix up these hollows also for possible birds to live in, which I doubt, but probably a high chance of getting bats, little bats, living in these hollows. All I've got to do with some of them is just block up the back of the holes and put some sheep wool in there, because the sheep wool is like a nice warm insulation for them. I've got plenty of sheep wool. And yeah, so hopefully in the next couple of years, year or so, I might have some beautiful bats nesting in my yard. And I've got heaps of stuff, guys. It's a nice backyard, heaps of tadpoles. I'm just about to go and catch a heap of tadpoles today to restock my ponds. We'll quickly go and show you some tadpoles if they're still here. So you can see them down there. There's a big one right there, really big ones. So I've got about probably 4 to 5 different species of tadpoles, guys. I'm going to forget them all. I've got the western spotted frog or toad. I've got the motorbike frog, the western banjo frog, some other burrowing frogs that I can't think of, the western toadlet, and others. So probably 5 to 6 species of beautiful frogs and tadpoles in my yard, guys. I absolutely hate fish ponds, guys, because they destroy the environment. People release them into farm dams and rivers, and as you know, those fish will absolutely kill everything. It's absolutely disgusting. There's a pet shop in my, just outside of Katanning, 50 kilometers from where I come from, and they sell turtles and all these awful fish. And just outside of Katanning, there's this beautiful paradise, one of the only last remaining freshwater long-term, full, you know, every year. And it's got native turtles in there, fish and all that. I guarantee you, from that Katanning pet shop, people will start dumping all their fish in that beautiful place in Katanning. If you ever go to Katanning, guys, it's called Policeman's Pool. It's a beautiful, beautiful spot full of turtles and fish, native fish, tadpoles and frogs. Reason it's called the Policeman's Pool is in the 1850s there was an old police outstation out there. So yeah, so anyway, guys, I love the environment, and I love anything to do with flora and fauna, frogs and tadpoles especially. All right, guys, so like I say, give me hints on mushroom growing, really appreciate it. See ya.